And the winner for the worst slash most awkward outro goes to Yankee Gamer 5. Oh, I'd like to thank the Academy, but anyway, oh my god. I just read back the file on that, and oh my god. My outros are absolutely worse. Don't peck his head, but anyway. Hey, and what is happening, guys? Yankee here. We're back for some more Let's Play Banjo-Kazooie. So right now, we're actually going to check out what's over here. I don't know. Why is Gobi hanging out with this nut guy? I don't like this. Look at this. This tree looks a bit thirsty, but I need all of my water for myself. Oh yeah, a little fun fact right here. You know camels and their humps and how everyone thinks water's in it? That's false. It's actually fat. Thank you, Snapple, or OMG Facts, I think it was. I don't know. Come on, I want to get on you. That sounded wrong. But what the hell? Oh my god, we got all this water out. Oh no. Ah, lovely water. Trunker feels great. Oh, I know Bubble will be appreciating that. Oh, what the hell? How do we get up there, man? You just grew like 10 centimeters. What is with all the that's what she said jokes in this opening half? Oh my god, I'm not even doing this on purpose. Ah, just Banjo-Kazooie, suggestive game. Very suggestive game. That's why I love Rare, you know? That's why I love Rare. They always push the limits. But I don't know, we don't really see any of those like kinds of jokes that we see in this and Conker's Bad Fur Day and like Donkey Kong Country and that. They're much more conservative than that, I don't know. I guess they were trying to just make like Donkey Kong Country like series just perfected and whatnot. They didn't really go for any jokes or anything, but then again, I don't think Donkey Kong and Diddy can talk. Or they ever exchange dialogue in the game, so very hard to put jokes in that game when no one can talk. Alright, so what we want to do here is get to the flying pad and do some flying around. Who would have thought that? I thought I was going to go swimming with the fly pad. Hadur! I don't know what you guys do with flying pads. Ah, man. So anyway, let's just go through this ring right here. We're going to be going, jumping through rings, literally. Alright, so let's see here. Summon all the hidden rings of the ancients to beat the witch. Okay, everyone seems to know what Grunty is or who Grunty is. That's kind of weird. Like, I don't know. Well, I don't know. It's probably much weirder that Grunty and Banjo have lived together for, like, the last, like, 20 years and they never noticed each other, but we're gonna walk away from that fact and go into this one because I don't know. Why does everyone know who we are and what they are? It's not like Banjo's ever left the house before. We don't know that. I don't think he has. The game never suggests that. Alright, so we gotta find that other ring. Where is that other ring? I can't really, like, you can't really get a good depth perception in this one, so. Or in this game, for that matter, so. Just kinda, I don't know, I'm just gonna keep on. What I do is, like, to fly all the way to the top and just get an aerial view. That's kinda neat. We have, like, a nice backdrop of pyramids back there. That's so stereotypical of freaking, like, Egypt and that. Pyramids. Well, I know it's the number one thing you think of, but oh, I see it back there. I just like to do the, whoa, kamikaze! Oh, man. So anyway, the ring's back here, so let's just get a nice little angle on that. Angle on the dangle. Oh, I missed it. Are you kidding me? You have got to be kidding me. I love how everything blinks in this. Why does everything have a face and talk? Oh, my God. Oh, okay, it's right there. It's right in the screen. That wasn't hard at all. All right, let's try to get one up here. Yeah, flying the cast be awkward because you're like, you don't want to go too high, you need to go high enough. It's just, I don't know, flying mechanics in this game are not bad, but they're just slightly awkward, I don't know. It doesn't help the fact that you only have a certain amount of flying time because you have to get as many red feathers as you can because then you can just run out of red feathers at any time. Take a breath right there. You deserve it. Alright, he was between cactuses and there's only like 5 cactuses in this world, so it's not that hard. It's right there, how did I miss that? There we go, definitely helps getting over a vast area over a limited time. Alright, so let's go in here. Is that it? Are we done? Only joking, mortal. We can only give you this. Oh, I want everlasting life. I can never get anything I want. Aw, man. At least Cheeto will help us. He'll give us everlasting life, right? Oh, wait, that's the next game. Oh, man. But anyway, this is Jiggy number 8, I believe, or 9? I don't know. I lost track. Oh, wow, it's number 9. Nice. The last Jiggy, where is it? I believe it's over here, actually. I'm just trying to think back in my little cranium right here. Yeah, I think it's over here. And we still gotta collect all the notes as well, so. And I'll see what Gobi's got back here. He's got another Jiggy? What are you holding on me, boy? Oh, it's an empty honeycomb. Bah! That's it! I'm leaving this desert to mind some peace and quiet! Alright, what the hell, man? Okay, I guess Gobi can walk on sand. I guess he's like the anti-Jesus. Or he's the camel Jesus. And oh, look at that! We get an extra honeycomb piece. Cool. Wow, now our health meter is looking very nice right there. I believe we can get two more additions to that, or one more. I'm not really sure. But I know towards the end of the game, you can get something ridiculous, but I guess we'll talk about that later. In the end of the game, they just give you anything. It's kind of like Castlevania with all the crap they give you at the end of the game. But anyway, where's that last Jiggy at? I'm just trying to think back. Did that, we did that. And let's just, actually, yeah, let's just read the totals right here. I haven't done that in a while. Okay, so we have 94 notes and 9 Jiggies. So I'm guessing where the Jiggy is that we haven't explored that area because we only have 6 notes left, and that's kind of random to not discover that already. They must be all together. So let's see here. We went in there. We did. Oh, wait, are they underwater maybe? Might be. Yeah, there we go. Their notes are underwater, okay. That just brings up the question of... Oh yeah, the last Jiggy is the Jinjos. I always forget about the Jinjos. Oh my god, they should have like, what they didn't have that I always wanted them to do was to have like a Jiggy counter up in the top right or top left maybe? It would make it so much easier because I always forget like which Jiggies I haven't gotten, which Jiggies to get. Oh really? We have to find the green one still? Damn you, you stupid green Jinjo. And yes, we found all 100 notes. Okay, whatever. Big whoop-de-doo. Alright, so I'm actually gonna look at my book now where to find that green Jinjo. Alright, let's see here. Okay, I found it. I found it. Yes, I found it. Okay. I can't believe I missed that up. I should have heard his voice. Because we've been to that area already. That was kind of weird. Oh well, because I was trying to find where the game guide's so disorganized. Like, doesn't even tell you, like, where to find exactly. But anyway, the Jinjo is back here in this hardest spot to find ever in this freaking map. Why would anyone look this way? It's kind of like that concave, like, thing that we couldn't find those notes in? Like, what the hell? Aw, man, enough of this world. So cryptic. Aw, man, so I'm as much as I'm glad to get out of this world, I'm kind of not. I'm gonna miss all the pocket sand. Oh, so many memories. Aw, man. I'm gonna miss you the most, Shinxie, out of all of you. Aw, man. And even Trunker, his heart grew 6 centimeters this day. Or his body. Or his thing. I'm gonna stop talking about that again! Oh no. Alright, so let's just use the waiting boots to get across the other side. Guess we'll solve that riddle of why the Kazooie crossed the road. Obviously, to get across the sand. Oh man, so anyway, let's make our way closer to the next world. What is the next world in this game? I kind of forget. Oh yeah, it's that world. Oh yeah, we have to get the thing, the Jiggy in the sarcophagus. Sarcophagus, that's kind of like, that has to be one of the coolest, oh yeah, we have to, in order to get this, Jiggy, we have to go like this, and I cannot see, but anyway, we end up there, and there we go, yeah, some razzmatazz right there. Ah, man, but anyway, the next world in the game is probably one of my least favorite slash most nightmarish worlds in the game, besides, you know how I mentioned Clanker's Cavern? This one gave me more nightmares than that. Yeah. That was the second world I never played, which is the next one. As an 8-year-old kid, I think I was 8. Yeah, I was 8. This next world gave me a lot of nightmares. I don't know why. I guess it was because it was like a scary area. I don't know. So anyway, now that we have the running shoes, we can actually get this next Jiggy, which is probably the hardest Gruntilda Jiggy to get. Because look at this. Watch what we have to do to get this Jiggy. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I have to do that first, just to show the freaking, like, tediousness of this, or the frustration of this. First step in order to get this Jiggy is to use your eggs on this, not knowing anything can go there. Yeah, that's a lot of sense, right? Come on, you can figure that out on the first try. Come on. That's not hard at all. Yeah, that's the first step of this freaking, I don't even know what I was going to say there. I ran out of things to call things. Oh my god, I'm awful. Alright, so let's just go up here. Gotta get the red feather switch. Hit the red feather switch and watch what happens. Oh, a red feather thing comes out. It's the first time we actually see a red feather pad in Gruntilda's lair. So you gotta use the running boots. That's step 3. Get over here as fast as possible. jump, and once you run out of time, the thing just disappears, so, you have to hustle as quickly as possible. And we want to break that eye for future references. I don't know why, but I guess you'll figure it out sooner or later. I think there's something on top of Gruntilda's hat over there, but I just want to get the Jiggy right here because... yeah, and we have to fly through this little crevice right here without touching the floor. That's step 5 in this freaking wonder bust. I don't even know if that's a word. This, clusterfuck. Yeah, that's the word. That's the word I was trying to say. Okay, we have to get down here. Come on. Come on. There we go. Okay, at least we're safe. And there we go. That's the second Gruntilda Jiggy we got in the last 2 minutes. And probably the hardest one in the game. Many tricks are up my sleeve to save yourself, you'd better leave. Okay, where am I gonna go? I'm kind of lost in your, lair right here, your labyrinth, so, yeah, point me to the exit. Oh, yeah, we have to save our sister. Oh, I forgot about that. I guess we have to stay. Oh, what a shame. What a pity. All right, so we want to do is keep on flying, because I think there is something important on top of her hat, so... they wouldn't just give you the fly pet just to give it to you, so... there's gotta be something up here. Oh, it's Gruntilda. Okay, there's nothing up here, folks. There's nothing up here. You are the least important character in this game. Just go! Ah, just get out of here. Just get lost. Oh, my God. Alright, what's under here? Oh, it's a cauldron thingy, okay. Oh, I thought we activated more than one, okay. Now, like I said, like, I think a couple, or a long time ago, if you can use the cauldrons to get very easily, across each of the areas in the labyrinth, so... not too bad, not too bad at all. What's this? A note door? Okay, 450, we definitely have that. We have 599, that's the grossest number ever! Oh my God. Not getting that one note is just killing me inside. Speaking of, we actually have to go to Freeze Easy Peak, I remember, huh? Alright. Guess we'll do that. I just passed the area. What am I doing? And why is my dog barking? I don't know. I don't know. So let's just go to Freeze Easy Peak and, get that last Jiggy we can get by using the running shoes, but I think that will have to end it off here because we're running a bit long on time. We'll just do that in the next one. So, thank you guys for watching. Next time, we'll be using the running shoes to beat out Boggy in another sled race and finish off Freeze Easy Peak and find the final note in the area. Yeah! Not an awkward outro. Not an awkward outro. Awesome sauce.